Hello students, welcome back to online session. This is Sridevi Alde from Appa Public School. Today I am going to explain you about movements of the earth. Okay, children, in last class what did you learn? You learned about latitudes and longitudes. Okay, what are latitudes and longitudes? Latitudes and longitudes are nothing but lines on the globe or earth. See children, the real earth does not have any lines. Understood children? Here, in order to study the earth, we assume that so and so lines are there on the earth. We learned so many definitions in last lesson. Equator, latitudes, longitudes, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. Next, 0 degree meridian, 180 degree meridian, grade, how to locate the places by using latitudes and longitudes. All these you learned in last class. Now in this class, we are going to learn about movements of the earth. Okay, here children, what is the earth? The earth is a planet. Okay, what is earth? The earth is a planet. How many planets are there? There are 8 planets. What are they children? They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. These are the 8 planets we have. See children, this is the solar system. Here in this solar system, we have 8 planets. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. These are the 8 planets we have. See children, these 8 planets, what are they doing? They are revolving around the sun. Okay, that means the Earth is also a planet. The Earth also revolves along other planets because it is one of the planets of the solar system. Here, children, while revolving around the earth does one more thing. What is that? It rotates on its own axis. Now you came to know that how many movements has the earth got? The earth has got 2 movements. Okay, what are they? How many movements has the earth got? The earth has got 2 movements. What are they? They are rotation and revolution. Okay, these are the 2 movements of the earth. Now let us study one by one. First one is rotation. What is rotation? Rotation is nothing but the movement of the earth on its own axis is called rotation. The movement of the earth on its own axis is called rotation. Okay, children, what is rotation? Rotation is nothing but the movement of the earth on its own axis is called rotation. See, children, what is axis? What is axis? About axis, I told in the first lesson only. Okay, what is axis? Axis is nothing but it is an imaginary line which connects North Pole and South Pole and passes through the center of the earth. This is the definition of the axis. Okay, see children, this is the earth. Here we have axis. This is called axis. It is an imaginary line which connects the North Pole and South Pole. Okay, and passes through the center of the earth. This is called axis. It is, say, inclined at an angle of 23.5 degree. It is inclined at an angle of 23.5 degree. Okay, children. Here, that means inclined means slant. How much time does the earth take to complete one rotation? The earth takes 23 hours, 56 minutes, and 4 seconds. See, the Earth takes 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds in order to complete one rotation. Understood, children? Here, daily we see the sun rise and setting of the sun. Okay, the sun rises and rising and setting of the sun. Where does the sun rise, children? The sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. Okay, the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. Okay, children. Here the earth rotates from west to east. See, this is the earth, this is axis. Okay, from here to here, the earth rotates like this from west to east. Because of that, what happens? See, it appears that sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. Actually, we are saying the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. No, it is not correct. Why it is not correct? Because the earth itself moves from west to east. That is why it appears like that. The sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. Understood, children? Here, daily we have days and nights. Okay. How we are getting days and nights? Due to the rotation of the earth. Due to the rotation of the earth, days and nights are caused. Okay. Days are caused due to the rotation of the earth. Understood, children? See here, due to the rotation of the earth, days and nights are caused. Okay, how days and nights are caused, let us see now. See, this is the earth. Okay, this is the earth. It rotates on its own axis. Okay, while rotating on its own axis, what happens? Only half of the earth's surface comes opposite to the sun. Okay, children? Here, the half of the earth's surface which comes opposite to the sun experiences sunlight. That means gets sunlight. This is called daytime. Okay. At the same time, the remaining half of the earth's surface does not get sunlight. This part remains in darkness. This is called nighttime. Okay. See, each and every part on the earth experiences daytime for some time and nighttime for some time. Daytime and nighttime both constitute a day. That means daytime and nighttime both form a day. Both forms the day. How many hours are there in one day? There are 24 hours. Okay, 24 hours make a day. Now let us see revolution of the earth. What is revolution, children? Revolution is nothing but, see, the earth revolves on its the earth revolves around the sun while rotating on its own axis. This is called revolution. Now let us see the definition. Revolution. What is revolution? The earth revolves around the sun while rotating on its axis. Okay, see here, what is revolution? Revolution is nothing but the earth revolves around the sun while rotating on its own axis. This movement of the earth is called revolution. Got it, children? What is revolution? This is the definition of revolution. The earth revolves around the sun while rotating on its axis. Okay, this movement of the earth is called revolution. Understood, children? How many days does the earth take to complete one revolution? Do you have idea, children? See here, the earth takes 365, one fourth days to complete one revolution. Understood, children? The earth takes 365, one fourth days to complete one revolution. That means it takes approximately 1 year to complete one revolution. Okay, here, due to the revolution, what are caused? Let us see now. What are caused due to the revolution of the earth? Seasons are caused. We have seasons now, different seasons we have. Summer season, winter season, rainy season, like that. We have seasons. How the seasons are caused? Seasons are caused due to the revolution of the earth. Okay. Seasons are caused due to the revolution of the earth. How are seasons caused? Let us see now. See, already I told you, children, that the earth's axis is inclined at an angle of 23.5 degrees. Okay, due to the slant of the earth's axis, only a part of the earth comes opposite to the sun. Okay, due to the slant of the earth. See, this is the slant. Okay, see, due to the slant of the earth, what happens? Only a part of the earth comes opposite to the sun. Okay, the part which comes opposite to the sun experiences sunlight. Okay, experiences direct sunlight. So, what happens? See, the part which experiences direct sunlight have summer season. Okay, at the same time, the other part which is not inclined towards the sun receives slanting rays of the sun. Okay, receives slanting rays of the sun. So, it experiences moderate temperature and have winter season. Understood, children? See, when the northern hemisphere experiences summer season, the southern hemisphere experiences winter season. When the southern hemisphere experiences summer season, the northern hemisphere experiences winter season. Okay, this is regarding seasons. Once again, I'll explain to you. See, here, due to the tilt of the earth, okay, due to the slant of the earth, only a part of the earth is tilted towards the sun. Okay, only a part of the earth is tilted towards the sun. See here, this is the globe. Understood, children? See, due to the slant of the earth axis, what happens? The earth is tilted. Okay, see, this side the earth is tilted. Understood, children? Due to the tilt of the earth, what happens? Only a part of the earth is tilted. See, due to the tilt of the axis, only a part of the earth is tilted towards the sun. So, what happens? The part which is tilted towards the sun receives direct sun rays. Okay, that is why that part experiences summer season. At the same time, the part which is not tilted towards the sun receives slanting rays of the sun. So, that is why what happened? It experiences winter season. Okay, when northern hemisphere experiences summer season, the southern hemisphere experiences winter season. When southern hemisphere experiences summer season, northern hemisphere experiences winter season. Okay. See. Next is, in this way seasons are caused due to the revolution of the earth. Next is, children, every year the earth has special positions. Okay. special positions. Okay, what are the special positions? Let us see now. First one is equinox. First one is solstice. Okay, first one is solstice and equinoxes. Okay, solstices and equinoxes. These are the special positions of the earth. See, what is summer solstice and what is winter solstice? Let us see now. See, on 21st June, okay, here, on 21st June, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. On 21st June, what happens? The northern hemisphere. See, this is the northern hemisphere, children. This is northern hemisphere and this is southern hemisphere. Okay, see, here what happens? On 21st June, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. Because of that, what happens? This is Tropic of Cancer. Okay, this is Tropic of Cancer. The direct sun rays fall on the Tropic of Cancer. Because of that, what happens? The areas which are lying on the Tropic of Cancer receives more heat and experiences summer season. At the same time, what happens? The North Pole is tilted towards the sun. That is why the areas beyond the Arctic Circle, this is called Arctic Circle, the areas which are beyond the Arctic Circle, what happens? They experience a complete daytime for 6 months. Understood, children? Next. Next on, see. This position of the earth is called a summer solstice. This position of the earth is called a summer solstice. See, next on 22nd December. Okay, next on 22nd December, the southern hemisphere. See, that means this is called Tropic of Capricorn. Here I'll write it. Tropic of Capricorn. Okay. See here. On 22nd December, the Tropic of Capricorn, which is in southern hemisphere, receives direct sunrays. That is why, see, the larger portion of the southern hemisphere experiences bright sunlight. That is why it experiences summer season. Okay, at the same time, in northern hemisphere, it happens opposite. Okay, here what happens? This southern hemisphere experiences summer season with longer days and shorter nights. Okay, as South Pole is tilted towards the sun. Okay, once again I'll repeat, children. See, on 22nd December, say Tropic of Cancer gets more sunlight. That means the direct sun rays fall on the Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn. Okay. See, children, on 22nd December, the Tropic of Capricorn, which is located in southern hemisphere, gets more sunlight. That means direct sun rays. So that is why what happens, the areas which are located in the southern hemisphere experience summer season. And at the same time, the South Pole is tilted towards the sun. And this southern hemisphere has summer season with longer days and shorter nights. Okay, see, in northern hemisphere, it happens opposite to the southern hemisphere. Understood, children? This position of the earth is called the winter solstice. Okay, this position of the earth is called winter solstice. See, once again, I'll repeat you about winter solstice. On 22nd December, the Tropic of Capricorn, which is located in the southern hemisphere, receives direct sun rays. That is why most of the places in the southern hemisphere have summer season. Okay, here South Pole is tilted towards the sun. Because of that, what happens? See, these areas experience summer season with longer days and shorter nights. See, in northern hemisphere, it happens opposite to the southern hemisphere. Understood, children? This position of the earth is called winter solstice. Now, next is equinox. See, on 21st March and 23rd September, okay, on 21st March and 23rd September, the sun rays fall directly on the equator. Okay, two times a year, the equator receives direct sun rays. Here, neither the poles are tilted towards the sun. Okay, that is why all the places on the earth have equal days and equal nights. Okay, this is called what? Equinox. This position of the earth is called equinox. Understood, children? By this, I finish the lesson. So, you have to open your textbook and read lesson twice or thrice, then you'll understand the lesson properly. Understood, children? See, all the assignments, whatever the assignments you are getting, no, you have to send them properly on particular day to your particular teacher. Understood? Thank you.